Good morning, everybody. New South Wales to 8 p.m. last night, we had just over 110,000 tests, which is positive, and continue to keep those high test numbers. But unfortunately, we had an increase in case numbers from yesterday to 291 cases of community transmission. There are a number of cases still under examination, but at least 50 of those were infectious in the community. And I do want to foreshadow that given this high number of cases, we're likely to see this trend continue for the next few days. So I do want everybody to prepare themselves for higher case numbers in the next few days. Just based on the trend in the last few days and where things are going, I'm expecting higher case numbers in the next few days, and I just want everybody to be prepared for that. But pleasingly, and I want to provide updates, we get information the preceding 2 days on how many people have been vaccinated in New South Wales. And on Wednesday, 84,000 people received a jab in New South Wales, which is fantastic. We really want to increase that number. The more people we get vaccinated, the sooner we'll be able to live more freely. And I really want to stress that point. Life for us on August 29 will be a reflection of how many people have at least one dose of the vaccine and where the case numbers are. And those two things are the things we'll look at to see how we can live beyond August the 29th. And obviously, once we hit the 70% vaccination rate, life will be much easier. And of course, once we hit the 80% vaccination rate, life will be as normal as we can expect during COVID. I do want to make three important points today. The Canterbury-Bankstown local government area is proving to be the area where cases are increasing the most. So all the suburbs in the Canterbury-Bankstown area really need to be on extra alert. There'll be more police on the ground. We are seeing too many people frequent certain shopping areas and perhaps not doing the right thing. So police will be more present in the Canterbury-Bankstown local government area to ensure compliance. And we have to make sure that happens, because we don't want to see these case numbers continue to grow into the next few weeks. Pleasingly, education and health have provided a roadmap forward for HSC students. So firstly, obviously the students who live in those eight local government areas of concern will not be able to have any face-to-face time for the foreseeable future until otherwise advised. However, in areas outside of those local government areas, there will be a flexible model for HSC students who need to go into the classroom for whatever reason in order to pick up material or do some face-to-face exams or whatever is required. But health and education have worked out a very safe way for that to occur. It won't be normal classes, but certainly it will be a level of presence to ensure that no students are disadvantaged in terms of acquiring their qualifications. Trials will be done at home. And at least it means that there is certainty and all students know they'll qualify for the HSC. But also, obviously, importantly, from Monday next week at Kudos Bank Arena, HSC students in those eight local government areas will be invited to get the Pfizer jab. And most of those students are between the ages of 16 and 18 years of age. And we do encourage all students to make sure they come forward for that opportunity, because obviously by the time everybody sits for the HSC exam, which is a requirement, we want every student from those eight local government areas to have been offered the vaccine and to have taken the vaccine. Just to stress that every student will receive an email on how to book online next week, and there'll also be a call centre set up for parents to call if they have any questions. There'll also be good advice on what is the safest way to get the student or for the students to go to the vaccination hub. We obviously want to avoid any gathering, any congregation, anything which breaches social distancing or any mixing of households, and that's really, really important. We certainly don't want the virus to spread whilst people are going to get vaccinated. I'm even prepared to read the call centre number, which will go online soon, which is 1800 922 886. So for parents who want information or for students, in addition to receiving an email on how to book, that call centre will be available for people to access to get information on how their student or the student can get vaccinated in those eight local government areas from Monday. I also, again, want to really, literally send out a call to arms to all arms in New South Wales. Please come forward and get vaccinated. I can't stress that enough. We are doing better than what we had previously in terms of the number of people getting vaccinated every day, and that's a positive. I can't tell you how important it is for us to get those vaccination rates up, because it will give government better options on what we can do moving forward, and certainly the health experts will feel more confident giving us advice once we know we have higher rates of vaccination. And I do want to provide ongoing updates to the community on how our vaccination rates are going, because that will ensure that we have targets to look forward to. And if we get to 6 million jabs by the end of August, that certainly gives us options from August 29. So I can't stress that enough. Thank you to all those people coming forward, and I hope you find the booking system and arrangements more easy to get through. And clearly, that is really critical for us at this stage. Thank you.
Thank you. There were 291 locally acquired cases of COVID reported in New South Wales to the 24 hours to 8 p.m. last night. And there are currently 304 COVID cases admitted to hospital with 50 in intensive care, 22 of whom require ventilation. And again, we see the pattern. The people that are in ICU are predominantly not vaccinated. With out of the 50 in ICU, 44 people are not vaccinated, 4 people received their first dose of AstraZeneca, and 2 people have received their first dose of Pfizer. So again, to reiterate, one dose does afford protection, some protection, but 2 doses is provides a greater degree of protection. So we've also recommended that in terms of AstraZeneca, please come forward if you've had your first dose of AstraZeneca within that 4 weeks period for your second dose. So bring that second dose forward to get that complete protection. In terms of deaths, sadly, we've had a woman in her 60s, a woman in her 60s from southwestern Sydney died at Liverpool Hospital. She tested positive for COVID on July 29, and she was not vaccinated. She acquired her infection in Liverpool Hospital, and that was a transmission in the hospital. This is the second death connected with the recent outbreak at Liverpool Hospital, following the death of a man in his 90s, which was reported on the 2nd of August. Can I personally extend my sincere sympathies to her loved ones? It must be a very challenging time for them. In terms of an update on the Hunter and Central Coast cases, I can confirm that there have been 2 new cases of COVID in the Newcastle area. There have not been any new cases reported from Central Coast. The 2 new cases in the Newcastle area mean that there have now been 7 cases in the region, and the Central Coast case numbers remain at 9. Of the 2 new cases in Hunter, one is a woman in her 60s, is linked to the known Central Coast household cases announced yesterday. And the second, a woman in her 20s, is a household contact of the case in Newcastle that we announced yesterday. So all of those new cases we're announcing are linked, but again, I am urging the Newcastle community and surrounds to come forward for getting testing so we can be assured that we aren't missing any chains of transmission. Obviously, Hunter and Central Coast, Hunter is in lockdown, similar to the same as Sydney at this time, and that's for a week. Now, clearly, once we get through this, we need those high testing rates to give us that assurance that we're not missing those chains of chains of transmission. Again, can I call out the areas by suburb that the Premier has indicated? What we're seeing is some flattening of the curve in Fairfield and some of our other local government areas. But what we're not seeing, we're seeing escalating cases in Campsie, Bankstown, Lakemba, Punchbowl, Wiley Park, Yagoona, Greenacre, Earlwood, Bass Hill, Canterbury and Chester Hill. So it is important for anyone going into that area for essential work, working in that area, living in that area, to be very, very vigilant. We are seeing transmission potentially around shopping areas. And so again, I urge everyone, do not enter shops when there are other people in the shop. Wait outside, keep your social distance, wear your mask correctly at all times, and stay safe.
Thanks, Kerry. I just want to direct my comments to the young people who are in the 8 LGAs of concern, local government areas of concern at the present time. You have your HSC coming up in October. And in order to be able to do that safely, for you to be able to go and to sit your exams, you're being given a golden opportunity to attend the Qdos Bank Arena next week. We've seen our Olympic stars go for gold. We've seen the most amazing stars in the Qdos Bank Arena. I think there's been Lana Del Rey, Keith Urban, Pink, Madonna, just so many people. You have the chance to go to that stadium next week and actually land some gold by getting your first vaccination, your first Pfizer vaccination. New South Wales Health and Education are doing everything to back you in and make sure that you can go safely to your HSC exams by October. But what we really need you to do is to go for gold next week. We have about 24,000 of you who can get along to the Qdos Bank Arena next week. And the way you do that is that there will be a link come out to you, there'll be messages come out to you with a letter that will explain what you are required to do. But what you are required to do is just keep safe, basically. Get along to the Qdos Bank Arena. You can get there by your own car or by public transport. Maybe mum and dad can drop you. If mum or dad or one of your family drop you, make sure they stay outside the arena, because we don't want too many people obviously milling around inside the arena. Make some arrangements for after you've got your access to that golden opportunity of the vaccination to wait outside for you. And to mums and dads, I just want to say, and to the young people themselves, that if you need to make a call because perhaps there's an issue that you're not quite certain about, or that the email that comes out to you, you've still got questions, then you can ring 1-800-922-886. I'll just repeat that number, 1-800-922-886. This is your big chance to really go for gold and to star next week. You're getting an opportunity that so many others haven't yet managed to achieve, and it's there for you, and it's there for you to really light up your future by having your safety and security looked after so you can sit your exams come October. I want to stress that to the mums and dads, your children will be well looked after inside when they arrive. They'll be literally ushered. We'll have nurses, we'll have some of the youth command, we'll have some of the young police from the various operations within police there just to guide them through as to where they go. They'll be looked after every moment inside the stadium, and they'll be well cared for. So mums and dads, feel secure. We've got about 24,000 students we're aiming to get through next week. The messages will come out this week, and the opportunity is there, but really you've got to take it, grasp it with both hands. I know... if you talk to any of our Olympians, I'll tell you, you just got to grasp opportunity, and this is an opportunity, so don't waste it.